Hi guys, welcome back to SG Dr. Wellness. My name is Dr. Chen Yiming. This is the first video of this sleep disorder series. Have you guys heard of obstructive sleep apnea? It is the most common sleep-related breathing disorder. It also has serious consequences on our health and wellness. Want to learn more about how to recognize obstructive sleep apnea and its treatments? Then be sure to watch till the end. If you are new to our channel, click on the subscribe button now. There are several types of sleep apnea, but the most common of which is obstructive sleep apnea, or OSA for short. When you sleep, all the muscles in the body become more relaxed. This includes the muscles that can help keep your throat open so air can flow into the lungs. Normally, the throat remains open during sleep to let air pass by. Unfortunately, many people have throat that has been narrowed due to various causes. When the muscles in the upper throat relax during sleeping, that narrowed throat closes in and blocks partially or completely the airway, leading to either a reduction or a full pause in breathing. Your brain will sense this impaired breathing and briefly rouses you from your sleep so that you can reopen your airway. This awakening is usually so brief that you don't remember it. This sleep and wake pattern can repeat itself 5 to 30 times per hour all night long, and this can seriously disrupt your ability to reach the deep restful phases of sleep, and you'll probably feel sleepy during your waking hours. A noticeable sign of obstructive sleep apnea is loud snoring. Risk factors for OSA includes obesity. Fat deposits around the upper airway can narrow the airway, and when the muscles are relaxed when you're sleeping, the extra weight can cause the airway to collapse and be blocked. Secondly, older age. We do know that the risk of OSA increases with age, but it plateaus off after your 60s. Third, narrowed airway for whatever reason. Some patients may have narrowed airway. It could be due to enlarged adenoids or enlarged tonsils, or they could have chronic nasal congestion of various causes, for example, like chronic allergic rhinitis. These narrowed airways will increase your risk of developing obstructive sleep apnea. Fourthly, your gender. Men are 2 to 3 times more likely than premenopausal women to have obstructive sleep apnea. However, the frequency of OSA increases in women after menopause. Fifth, family history. Having family members with obstructive sleep apnea will increase your personal risk of having it as well. Sixth, smoking. Smoking is associated with an increased risk of OSA. So, what are the symptoms of obstructive sleep apnea? Symptoms of OSA may include excessive daytime sleepiness, which may cause you to fall asleep while working, watching television, having your meals, or even driving. How dangerous can that be? You may also experience difficulty in concentration during the day, mood changes such as irritability or even depression, morning headache, awakening with dry mouth or sore throat, even reduced libido. Signs of obstructive sleep apnea, which is usually observed by your partner, not by yourself, includes loud snoring, observed episodes of stopped breathing during sleep, abrupt awakenings accompanied by gasping or choking, and even high blood pressure. So be sure to speak to your doctor if you snore loudly, especially if your snoring is interrupted by periods of silence. As I've mentioned, OSA is not just a sleep disorder. It can affect the patient's health and mental well-being. Firstly, it increases your chance of getting cardiovascular disorders. OSA can be a cause of hypertension. OSA can also increase your risk of getting coronary artery disease, heart attacks, and even heart failure and strokes. There's even an association with irregular heart rhythm. Secondly, it can affect your performance in school or at work. Because of the lack of restorative sleep, people with OSA suffer from severe daytime fatigue and irritability. They will have problems concentrating and find themselves falling asleep at work, and that puts them at a high risk of work-related accidents. Even worse, some patients may fall asleep even when driving, and then that can lead to serious road traffic accidents. For children and students, they may do poorly in school, and they commonly have attention or behavior problems. Thirdly, it can be detrimental to your mental well-being. People with OSA can suffer from morning headaches, they can be very irritable, they can have mood swings, and some even develop depression. Their memory may be affected, and sometimes it may even affect their relationship with their partners because the partners may choose to sleep in another room to escape the loud snoring. So, how can OSA be diagnosed? There are sleep study tests that can be done both in the laboratory and even at home. In a formal sleep study, you can be hooked up to equipment that monitors your brain activity, your vital signs, your breathing patterns, your blood oxygen levels, and even your limb movements while you sleep in the lab. The results of this test can formally diagnose you with OSA. Nowadays, there are simpler devices which you can wear while sleeping at home to make a diagnosis too. For example, the watch pad. Now, after a diagnosis has been made, treatment should be started as soon as possible. Treatment for OSA is generally divided into surgical and non-surgical methods. Firstly, make lifestyle changes. Lose weight if you are overweight. Exercise regularly and reduce your overall calories intake. Secondly, quit smoking and drinking. Thirdly, treat your chronic allergic rhinitis if you have nasal decongestions and allergy medications. Fourthly, avoid taking sedative medications. Oral mouthpieces may also be prescribed by your doctor if you have mild to moderate apnea. These devices are designed to keep your throat open, and that sometimes can relieve snoring and OSA. The last non-surgical treatment option will be that of a positive airway pressure device. This machine delivers air pressure through your nose or through your mouth while you sleep. By doing so, this positive pressured air can help open up your narrowed or closed airway while you're asleep. This treatment has been shown to reduce daytime sleepiness and improve quality of life. In the event non-surgical options are not effective, then surgery may be recommended. Some of the surgeries that are performed includes tissue removal surgeries where organs or tissues found to be obstructing the airway are removed. Jaw surgery, where the position of the jaw is adjusted to enlarge the space behind your tongue and soft palate. Upper airway stimulation, where a small device is implanted into your chest, and this small device can deliver an electrical impulse that triggers tongue movement when it senses an airway obstruction. Thank you for watching till the end. Obstructive sleep apnea should not be ignored as it has long-term serious health implications. Treatments are available. Consult your doctor today to get it checked. In next week's video, we'll be talking about snoring. Subscribe, like, and share this video. Until the next time, stay safe and stay healthy.